to Ahlul Bayt, or the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ibn Umar radiyallahu anhuma reported Abu Bakr radiyallahu anh said, show reverence to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam by honoring the members of his family. Bukhari. In this hadith, the love and respect for the members of the Prophet's sallallahu alaihi wasallam family has been tied with the love and respect of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In other words, a person who loves and respects the descendants of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be deemed to be a lover and admirer of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. On the contrary, one whose heart is devoid of the love of the descendants of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be considered devoid of the love and respect of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But love and respect here does not mean that they are taking for sinless persons and their status is exaggerated beyond reason, as in the case with the Shia. Their whole religious thinking is founded on the exaggeration of the qualities of the members of the family of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they have exhausted their imagination in proving them sinless. While their love and respect lies in adopting the noble features of their character and cherishing their piety, their love and respect does not lie in sentimental attachment with a particular family and exaggerating its praise beyond all limits. Wallahu alam. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin.
Bismillah walhamdulillah wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. Inshallah, before I start, a small comment about what we just heard. Exaggeration and exceeding the limit that been drawn by Allah or His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam is danger for the Muslim and is not acceptable. And as a result of this, we see the concern of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even in the moment of hardship and difficulty, before he died, and he was facing the death, and he was still talking about the seriousness of exaggeration. And he reminded us about what happened with the previous nations from the Jews and the Nasara, that they took from the graves of their prophets places of worship. And by that, he was warning his ummah not to follow their steps. So there is a limit for things, and there is a line that the Sharia had drawn for us to keep us on the Sirat al-Mustaqim. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us, لا تطروني كما أطرت النصارى عيسى بن مريم. Do not exaggerate in me like the Christian exaggerated in Jesus, son of Mary. Indeed, I am a slave servant of Allah and His Messenger. So say His servant and His Messenger. Believing that human being, any of a human being, to know the unseen or that has equality from the qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is deviation and it bring to a kufr and shirk. And that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, do not exaggerate in me, same way like the Christian exaggerated in Isa. their exaggeration brought them to the end to say that he is Allah or the son of Allah. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam warning his ummah because he cared for his ummah. And he doesn't want his ummah to go astray and to be like the other nations. Not in the Prophet, not in the awliya or the sheikhs. And one of the forms that the people do exaggeration in it with the scholars, that they take their statement to be a sharia, while they see the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some people, they take the school of thoughts as the ultimate authority, although that they see the Quran and the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying something different. So this, it became a way of people going astray, not following the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not being listening to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we can see how the Shia in general believe in their leaders to be the spokesman or the one who act in behalf of Allah or talking in behalf of Allah on the earth. They give them authority to make things halal or haram. Even they believe in their imams to be greater than the Prophet or the Prophets, while they believe that they know when to die and where they are going to die. And all these things is not lining up with the deen of Islam. So we have to be in the limitation of Islam concerning our love, our obedience, anything in relationship with the human being. And to still to understand that a human being is still a human being, they can make mistakes, they can forget. Even the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused him to forget in the salah. So the ummah can learn how to correct the mistake when they make mistakes in the salah. So one day the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, instead of praying dhuhr 4 rak'at, he prayed 2 rak'at. And he been questioned by one of the sahaba called Dhul Yadayn. And he said, O Prophet of Allah, is the salah been shortened or you forgot? And the answer of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that the salah was not shortened, neither he forgot. He said, no, Prophet of Allah, you forgot. You made a mistake in the salah. So here, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam turned to the Sahaba to see how accurate this information, and they confirmed the statement of Dhul Yadayn, and they said, yes, O Prophet of Allah, you pray only 2 rak'at. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went back again and continued the prayer. And after this, he prostrated 2 sajda sahu for forgetting, to show them and teach them how to correct their mistakes in the salah. As for this segment of this morning, inshallah, one with the mannerism and behavior, discipline that been discouraged and prohibited by Islam, which you call ghish. And ghish means deceiving. Letter gha, ghin and sheen. Or G-H-I-S-H. So this is not acceptable in Islam. Neither is supposed to be the behavior of any Muslim male or female in any fashion, action or saying. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one day he went to the marketplace and he saw subrat ta'am. فأدخل يده فيها فأصابت يده الشريفة بللا فقال ما هذا يا صاحب الطعام قال يا رسول الله أصابته السماء فقال هل جعلته فوق الطعام حتى يراه الناس من غشنا فليس منا وفي رواية من غش فليس منا. So the Prophet went to the marketplace and was a pile of food. Somebody was selling food like wheat, rice, grain. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he stick his hand in this pile of food. The food from outside looked dry. But when he put his hand in the inside of this pile, he felt wetness. The food was wet. As if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired him to check this product, to stick his hand inside to see what's going on. The outside looks nice and dry. But when he stick his hand inside, he see it wet. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam simply, he asked the man, what's wrong? And this to teach us that we didn't want to reach a conclusion about things before we ask. Assumption is no good. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, إِنَّ بَعْدَ الظَّنِّ إِثْمٍ. Some of the guessing are sin. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked the man, what is wrong with the food? He said, O Prophet of Allah, it was raining. And this is what happened. So this is fine, we know the cause, but why the inside different from the outside? This is something else now. Yes, it was raining, the food got wet, but why you hiding the wet food or the spoiled food, the bad food inside while the outside look good? So this is a form of deceiving. This is the action of deceiving. So the people will see it, they will buy it according to what they see, but when you go home, you will find something totally different, or mix good and bad. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to the man, whosoever deceive is not one of us. In another narration, whosoever deceive us is not part of us. And again, we'll go to the term that we were talking about yesterday and the day before, that is not part of us, or he is not a believer. Again, this does not make a person out of the Muslim community, that mean out of the fold of Islam that turn to a kafir. But it means that you are not behaving as a Muslim. You are not having the mannerism of a believer. You are not acting as a member of the Islamic community. All right? That means this is not acceptable, but does not mean the person became a kafir or became non-Muslim. So the Prophet told him, "Laysa minna, man ghasha falaysa minna." Laysa means not. Minna, us. He's not part of us. So does not mean he got out of Islam and he became a Jew or a Christian or a kafir or whatever. But it means that what you're doing is not line up with Islam. This is not the proper behavior. So the deceiving is not acceptable. And the Prophet ﷺ said that the buyer and the seller, they have the choice to keep their contract or to dissolve as long as they're still in the same spot of the market. He said, فَإِنْ بَيَّنَا بُورِكَ لَهُمَا فِي بَيْعِهِمَا أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. If both of them, they've been honest and clear about what they're doing and the transaction, Allah will bless both of them. Otherwise, the barakah, the blessing, will be removed from this bargain. So the person who's selling and the person who's buying, both of them, they have been truthful and honest about the product and about the money, the exchange, everything. Both of them, they have to be clear about the issue. And as long as they're still there in the marketplace where they conducting the transaction, they still have the choice who's going with the agreement or dissolve it. After you take the product and you leave, this will be it. Okay? So, tibyan, explanation, clarification is a must. A Muslim have to be clear and direct to the point, not to make the person assume something different. You're saying something, but is not saying what it is, and giving the person a chance that to misunderstand you. And this is not acceptable in Islam. If you're selling something and the person asking you about the product or the country or the place or whatever it is that related for him to determine the right price or not, you have to be straightforward. Now, I'm not buying all these things decreed for you. You have to trust in Allah. What's for you is for you. What's not for you is not for you. But don't give him the assumption that this, yes, this is what you're looking for. Yes, this is from such a country, or this is the size of what it is. Okay? Because the barakah and the blessing, yes, you will sell the product, but the barakah is not going to be there. So we have to understand that is not what you catch or cash in your hand. Is how Allah will bless such a thing. So there is something called barakah, called blessing, that Allah will make the impact of the little to be a lot. Okay? And Allah can make the quantity, the great quantity, to be less in the effect and the impact. Why the barakah is not there? We read in Quran, تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير. Blessed is the one who is in his hand is the dominion. So say the blessing comes from Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the little a lot, okay? And will make the little sufficient. As a result of this, he finds that the Muslim, he eats in one stomach, but the kafir eats in seven stomach. This means, later they say, حَسْبِ مْرِئِنْ Muslim لُقَيْمَاتٍ يُقِمْنَ صُلْبَ. It's sufficient to the Muslim few morsels to keep him upright and straight, okay? He doesn't have to fill his stomach all the way because it's sufficient for him, okay? But if you really want fill your stomach, so it'll be up to the third, the max. Third for your food, third for your drink, and third for your nafas, okay? Breathing,
yeah.
Air, okay? But the kafir will eat and eat and eat and is still hungry. The barakah is not there. So we have to believe in the barakah and the effect that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put in things. All right? So it's not by the thing itself, but by the way how Allah will bless it. And this is the result of this. You see, there is barakah in the umr, barakah in the food, blessing in the age, blessing in the money, okay? He found some of these great scholars, they did not live too long. But in a small period of their lives, they accomplished a lot. Okay? He found a person who maybe lived for a short period of time, but Allah had blessed him that he catch Laylatul Qadr in Ramadan 5-6 times, as example, during his life. So the way how Allah bless things. So we don't be greedy and they try to push products and selling things, okay? Because we want the money and this it, and as a result of this, we give false information. So a person is not supposed to deceive in action or by saying, or making, leading the person to believe about something which is not as is. Again, this is not a behavior of a Muslim, all right? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam counts this person not to be behaving according the Islamic adab and the behavior of the Muslims, all right? Deceiving come in different forms, like I say, can be in action in a forum or in a saying. As example, if a person going to marry a woman, so when she come for him to see her, she may be wearing a high heel shoes. Okay? So the man, when he see her, he will think that she stole her. All right? But later on, he found that she's short, as example. All right? There is nothing wrong to be tall or short or whatever, but a person may be looking for a certain quality, okay? So it shouldn't be deceived or putting certain clothes to make the person look different from what they are. Or try understand to, like when people go for a business meeting, they may understand get a car, a rental car, and go get sticker. They have now this kind of magnet sign. So now you will go put this in the car, which is a rental car, right, or a big truck, and put these things from both sides. So when you stop there, the people will think that you have a big company and establishment and things like this. So anyway, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one knows this. People are not going to know it. They will get to know later. Okay? They will get to know later. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ya'lamu kha'inat al-a'yun wa ma tukhfi al-sudur. He knows the deceiving of the eye and whatever the heart is hiding. So dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah knows what's going in your mind, what's going in your thoughts, why you're doing such a thing, okay? Or sometimes that you may put the book or whatever in a different angle. So the person, when he see it, he will think that this is what it is. Some people, as example, they have the old scale, the old-fashioned scale, have two sides. So people, they will go and tie a weight in the other side where you put the product. So they put 1 pound metal here, and they put the vegetable on the other side. But while in the other side there is already a piece of metal, he hooked the scale to make the other side heavier. There is people, as example, they put the good oranges in the front. The people will see it, but the bad oranges is there. They have bagged already half of it been filled. So now it will make you pick up whatever you like, but when you want 1 kilo or 2 kilo, you already have the bags. But people, they've been trained already. They've already been practicing these things for years. So it's easy for them to do it, but you as a person, a buyer, are not going to pay attention. So while you're picking the good oranges, you already have a bag that half of it already been filled. And he will take from you and keep putting on top of it. And after this, when you go home, you find things totally different. Okay? Labeling the clothes or whatever that you buying with different name, different brand, all right? All these things, you understand, is not supposed to be. Why again now we want warn about these things? Because this brings about hatred among the Muslim members of the community. You will dislike your Muslim brother. He had deceived you. He did not give you your right that what you pay more for what you got. And Islam is concerned about brotherhood, sisterhood. How is the people to stay together? So when you see that somebody trick you, you are not going to like this. You see? You are not going to feel good about it. So anything that disturbs brotherhood in Islam is not acceptable. You found the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam talking about three people sitting together. So two people could not conversate in secret, whispering to each other, was the third person sitting there. Because anything will disturb or bring about assumption or bad thoughts, it will disturb the brotherhood. So the deceiving is one of the things that will bring about animosity and hatred and break the brotherhood that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to be established. And a person who doing this is because he is not believing in Allah, he's not fearing Allah properly. As a result of this, he choose tricking to make money instead of being patient and accepting honest life. Inshallah, with this, close for this segment. If anybody have a question or comments, inshallah, related to the subject. If you have a question, I keep making mistake and say comments. Comments, there is no comments here in Islam. Okay? Because you know or you don't know. So maybe this is my mistakes. As a result of this, the people go and give their stories in life about things like this. And sometimes the class get longer and some people, they don't like this. So I mean that if you have a question or something is not clear for you to ask. Yes, sir.
The spelling of Ghash.
Ghain and Sheen, two letters in Arabic. In phonetics, G-H-I-S-H.
And what you said the meaning was?
Deceiving.
Deceiving, yeah.
Any question?
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Okay. As you spoke about two brothers maybe sitting, and there's a third brother there, and they're speaking about something in privacy, would that be the same thing if the one brother is just of an English dialect and two brothers have a different language and they start speaking a different language and he is there present?
Exactly. It's the same result. It's the same effect. Because the Prophet says that this will sadden the person, the third person. And shaitan will play in his mind.
Right.
He will assume that they're talking about him. So the Prophet said for them to wait. So what does it mean that you understand and go to Habib and say, sa, 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 taka, they understand? And Abdul Rahim sitting there is, oh. Because if something is not against Abdul Rahim, why we are not talking?
Right.
All right?
Right.
And maybe it's not about, but still, the shaitan always there to bring about animosity and to bring about hatred and disturb the people and put them against each other.
Mm-hmm.
And how many times in Islam that warning us about the shaitan, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوْ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوَّ. So the shaitan, he knows how to bring about ill feeling. So the Prophet says this will sadden the person because you whisper into him. But the other way that both of us talk English and the third person, he doesn't understand English. But there is a common language, like all of us can talk Chinese. But now I'm going to talk to him English and this person doesn't know English. So the same result will come. Okay? The same result will be there. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what he's saying? So you say to wait until you this verse. So that means the person left or both of you left and now you can talk about what you want.
Right.
Or wait until a fourth person will come and join the meeting. So now if you want to say to your brother something, there is two people. The possibility that, oh, Abdul Rahim say, oh, it's me. Or Abdullah will say me. Or the other person will say he's talking about me. But you could not say for sure that you're talking about me. Because you is the third. But if there is four and more, it's different. So using another language. All right. Whispering. Both of them is not proper. The people have to wait until this person leave or until you, both of you, leave and discuss it or that a fourth person will join the crowd. And Allah knows best. Yes, sir.
You mentioned something. I got lost. An example you used about like an name brand clothes or clothes with something on it, with a name or something.
Selling a product, like the jeans as example, or the Nike. So Nike is a brand, and people pay a big money for this, as if is a Nike, or whatever you want to call the product. Because they know, it's been known, well established among the people, that Nike shoes, as example, stay for 3 years. So you go get something fabricated, made with the same sign or the same logo, and a person buying it assuming that this is Nike. So now you sold him something that usually the people pay $100 for it. He's selling it for $50. He thought this is a catch. He didn't buy it because it's $50, because he bought it because the price is so low than the other stores. But if he know that this is not Nike, he's not going to buy it for 50. So now he made the 50. He took this later on after 3 weeks. The whole shoes, you understand, is not in the feet anymore. His big toes taken out, and you understand the ties is, could not be Nike, because Nike can be wearing for 3 years. You get tired of it, and after this you go, got it on internet and sell it again. You see, or in the, or some place. So now you get to know after using it, so you got to know, okay, now it's too late. A person is gone.
Now, I'm going to touch on that. Now, just that, if that person sold that product, that inferior product, for a superior price, wouldn't that be riba?
Riba is different things. The riba is alone bring a benefit. Both of them are haram, both of them are wrong, but the term riba, because riba mean yarbu, mean to grow.
Interest.
Okay? Something like is one, became one and a half, became two, became three. It's keep growing. Riba.
So is it?
Do you understand the term riba now? Riba. I'm only focusing about the word riba so you don't mix it with other things. Riba is haram, usury is haram, interest is haram. Deceiving is haram, lying is haram. But the term riba means something that was that much and after this is grow more. Like the bread. When you put the yeast in it and the start
rise.
This is called growing, called riba, rubber, okay? So the riba, it comes from this root of something grow and became bigger than what it was. So now I give you $100. When you return it, been agreed already that you have to bring in $110. So this $10 was increased. So this what you call riba. So this what you did is something different. It's not riba, but it's still haram.
So it's not. So what is usury?
Usury, interest, riba, all this is the same.
Right, it's the same usury. Because there was the reason why I asked that, there was a hadith where one of the Sahabas, somebody was selling dates, and the Prophet he mixed in the inferior dates with the superior, with the good ones, and the Prophet told him that this is either riba or usury. I don't remember which one, but this is what brought me to that.
Okay. So there are certain products you have to sell it with the equal amount. Okay, one of them, like barley, dates, and things like this. And you say 1 pound is 1 pound, or 1 cup, exchange it with 1 cup. Now, after I exchange it, now you can go with the price and buy a different dates. But there is certain things, like gold to gold, silver with silver. You could not have 24 karat gold, okay, 5 grams, exchange it with 24 karat gold, 4 grams. You could not do this because this will be an interest, or you call it riba or whatever. It have to be equal amount for the exchange. Otherwise, you're getting more. For what? No reason for getting what? You see? So if you use the word interest or riba or
usury
or whatever it is, this is different from cheating and selling something with other price, which is the price of the other product. Yes.
If you let the people know that what you're selling is bootleg, or however you say it, is it, would it still be all right if it's their choice to buy it?
Yes, if you let them know that this is not a Nike shoes, so now he what he's going to buy it for? He's going to buy it for $50, assuming that it's a Nike. So now if you telling him that this is not Nike, he want to buy it, he's not, you understand, fool to take it for 50 because now he's going to say, no, I'll take this for $20 or $10. I don't see why a person going to still buy it. Yeah, you explain you did your part. You explain you did your part. Okay? But will you think somebody still going to give you $50 for it? No way.
They check. Well, I know you and her. They know this stuff. But you got certain shoes that they cost $250.
Too much, yeah.
You going to get them. It's common sense. They know.
Is people will buy to understand only now. Yes, he will buy because he want to look like to look like in front of the people that I'm wearing. In like this was a kid stuff now. You understand that I'm wearing a Nike shoes. You understand like. Because, like, understand all this white rich boy, you understand the school wearing $120 or $200. So this poor guy understand what he can do. He go buy something like this. So he be standing there in the day of graduation. He look like you. Okay.
Boasting.
You see, this Brian. Is yeah.
His question is that can I sell these fake things?
It's not the fake now.
Yes, fake. This is Nike.
That's what he said.
Original company is selling.
Counterfeit
is selling. Officially, this is not allowed.
We are not dealing with legality here. We're talking about Islamically.
Islamically,
morally, you understand the person know that this is not Nike. Now, if you breaking the law, this is something different.
Yeah.
You're breaking the law that they say you are not supposed to sell things like this because usually people are not going to tell you.
Yeah.
This is a bootleg. They are not going to tell you. They don't tell you this.
We want that money.
Okay? So if this is in the law that you are not supposed to do this and you knowing that doing this, you're harming yourself, you can go to jail. Mm-hmm. Now this is your problem now. Now you doing something to harm yourself as a Muslim. You see?
So Sheikh, so what if I wanted to buy a car from you and the car looks good, you know, everything looks nice, but you tell me, say, well, Ms. Powerful, I got the radiator needs to be fixed and the transmission slips sometime. So if you tell me what's wrong with the car, can I still buy it? That wouldn't be deceitful. Oh.
No, this is what we're saying, that you need to clear.
Clear.
Doesn't matter whatever it is, a car, is a donkey, is a camel, you understand, is a wife, anything, you have to. You have to clear this matter. Now it's up to you to take it or not. This is what it says, that al-bay'ani bil-khiyar. Fa'in bayana, if they explain to each other, okay? But I don't come with something like here, and after this I take some glue and do it like this. Matter of view, as soon you take it and you go home, put it in the table, it fall apart. But I didn't, you could not see. But you get the crazy glue and you bought it and you keep until a person take it, you get the dollar and this it. So now if you tell him that this is broken, is used, okay, and I did it with glue. Okay, now this is okay. Yes, sir.
You give an example like say Habibullah. Say he has, you know, he makes his brand of chili, and he puts on the front of it Habibullah's chili. And then me, as his Muslim brother, I see he's having success. He's selling millions of these, and then I go make my own chili, and instead of putting Anwar's chili on, I put Habibullah's chili on it. So it's the same thing. A lot of people say, well, it's the kufar. He's ripping people off by charging $200 for this. So it should be fair for me to rip him off to sell. So is it different because it's a...
Yeah, but the people going to pay $200 for it because they say Habibi Chili. But if they're going to know this not Habibi Chili,
right,
this
but,
is Anwar,
right,
they are not going to pay
$200. Right, that the question that I'm saying is that what you're doing, though, is the same as if I'm taking... Nike and
the person who's doing, the person who fabricating the shoes, now he's doing something wrong.
Okay.
But me myself, I'm buying and I'm selling. I'm not talking about legality now. I bought.
So if it's
no law about it.
No. So if I did it, so let's ignore the law for a second. So if I did that to Habibullah, so I could come back to him and say, hey, the cops aren't coming after me. I'm sorry. I'm still selling this chili that has your name on it. That's the question I have.
They're not going to do nothing to Habib. They're going to lock you up.
No.
What I'm saying is that the people who made it.
No. I want to ask. No. I'm asking him this question specifically because now what's going to happen is he and I are going to have a
problem.
Because I'm what should be his. I'm stealing something from him, my
and
Muslim brother.
Deceiving. Yeah.
Well, let's leave that alone. But so now he's going to have. There's going to be a hatred for him because now he's like.
Yeah.
Well. He's got my name and he's using it for something.
Yeah.
Let's leave the police out of it. Say they never catch up with me for 30 years. I just never do. But now I still have something wrong that I've committed against him.
Okay. Basically, all what I'm saying, deceiving. Because we can go in many examples, okay? Mm-hmm. Are you with the person you're making transaction? Does he know what you're selling to him or not?
Okay.
If you mislead him by action or words, and he bought this from you, assuming that this is silver, but it's not silver, because you gave him a story, I went to such a place, and I bought this, and he got to conclusion that this is what he's looking for, but it's not, this is not right. Okay? Now, we're going to take a branch about somebody and somebody, is this? We're never going to finish it. Are you deceiving somebody?
Yes.
Or you stealing something that is not belong to you? As example, I give you a simple example. I was in a Charleston and after this, I found one of my videos. Okay? And it say Adley production and have BO boxes, the same thing, everything. I say, what? It didn't bother me that somebody selling my video. But what it bothered me, the person is not putting his own tag, his own address on it. So he is producing them and is still carrying my address.
Yeah.
And what happens that one day somebody sent me in the mail, say I bought a DVD, and it's not working, and he asking me back $10. But I know that I'm not selling DVDs, all right? And if I have DVDs, I will have a record of this person buying from me. So now I found that this person producing the stuff, so when somebody have a fault with the product,
right,
the fault will be falling on me. You see what I'm saying now?
Yeah.
So this is okay. Somebody else produces their DVDs, okay? But it still has the address, okay? Of the publisher, my address.
They are reproducing.
Oh, okay.
They burning.
I got you now.
And selling it.
I'm just little shit. I got you.
And selling it under his name.
Okay.
Okay.
I got you.
Without his permission.
Okay.
So now that the person. He making the profit, but if somebody have a problem with the product, he will come back to me because the address is my address.
And your name, okay.
You see, the address is mine, and actually had to have the person asking refund. All right?
Well, I'm not gonna
and
buy
this is a Muslim
anymore.
Brother, okay?
He's cheating.
And I have a bookstore and selling these things in New York.
Yeah.
And I was shocked, you understand? Because when I saw, I know he understands what's my brother cloak. I have no problem over the product itself to say my lectures because my information is in the internet. You can download it for free.
You want it.
But he used the return address.
Yeah.
Also mine.
Okay.
But when you approach him, Billy, man, what did he say? What was his response?
I have to go to New York to see where is he to talk
brother
to.
Talu called him, Sheikh, and he had like 100 more. We asked him how many DVDs they
I
had.
I know.
Yeah, we called the brother in New York. He said, how many you have?
I got a lot. Okay, we just sent a hit squad there.
So basically what I'm saying is that, let's you understand, harming the Muslim, harming a Muslim by any means, okay, is not acceptable. Okay? So same thing like now, you understand, if I'm making this DVD, it costing me $100 to produce the copy. I go get a cameraman and get a studio and all the things. And after this, I have to sell this DVD for $25 to cover my expenses. So now one person will get this DVD, and now he produce it and sell it for $5. So now I could not sell my DVD because somebody else is getting it for $5. So he harmed me indirectly because I could not even pay my cost for a studio, for a cameraman, all these things. All what you have to do, put one here and one here in the computer and click. He did it in a minute. Now he's making the money without even my... So harming a Muslim, taking his property, taking his ideas, you understand, and produce it, it's taking part of your time, taking your effort. Why people could not be honest with each other and go say, brother, I need some money or I need some assistance, I need this and that.
That's
what it is, you understand? So whatever now about what is the law and what's the boot and the camp and they understand these things, you could not deceive the people. You could not deceive the people, Muslims or non-Muslims. Because like I said, one hadith is saying, man ghashana, whosoever deceive us, and one hadith is saying, man ghasha, whosoever deceives. This it. So you have to have trust in Allah. If this dollar for me is coming to me, it's not. So I'll tell the people, this is what I got. Okay? Now you want to buy it as is, and you don't want to leave it. Leave it, and somebody else, Allah will come and somebody will come and say, "But I will say, man, I'm about to leave." He say, "I give you $5, but give it to me. It's broken. I still need this one." Okay, but we have to have the trust in Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, not to feed ourselves through crooked means. Allah knows best. All right, guys, I was not planning even for this session this morning.
No attendance?
No, I locked myself out of the house and out of the office and everything. So, but I have my phone with me, alhamdulillah, and they say.
So, exercise this morning?
Huh?
Exercise?
No, this only once a month.
Okay.
Once a year. Okay.
Yeah, shit, you was wide open yesterday. You didn't want to stop.
He needed me.
Yeah, middle arm.
No, this is what happened.
I have to
run and go get my medicine, inshallah. Inshallah, we'll make it up for you tonight, inshallah.
So where's your keys? In the house?
Yes.
Oh, so you didn't lose?
No. Inshallah, the
are
in the
house.
Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Anybody want the verse?
The verse? Oh, yeah.